I'm gay.
All right, Chad.
I'm gay.
I'm gay.
I'm gay.
Six gay men versus one secret straight man.
When did everyone realize they were gay?
I think... I think this guy is gay. He gives me the vibes, chat. I think this guy.
Gay.
Probably, like, end of high school, after my first relationship, it was a girl, and it was just not for me.
I think for me, it was in middle school.
Standard.
It was, like, before puberty. So I was just kind of figuring things out for myself. And also other kids were understanding too. So that really helped me to find myself when I would talk about it.
Oh wait, we have to find one straight guy. Oh, I think he's straight. I think he is, he's trying too hard.
15.
Oh.
So I know exactly when it was. I grew up in a very religious home. And I too was in relationships with girls. So what I did was I hid myself for a long time. So it's I'm trying not to tear up. It wasn't until the pandemic.
That sounds so fake.
When I came out to my little brother.
I'm trying to tear up.
I actually knew when I was 8. My grandma took me to see Mamma Mia. And if you've seen the movie, you know the beach scene. You know exactly what I'm talking about. And I knew something was just a little bit off about me when I realized that I was more attracted to Sky than I was Sophie. I'm like, something about him.
You know, mine honestly is right after Twilight came out. Like Robert Pattinson, I don't know.
So yo, good. Who's team? So who's good. Team? So good.
Of course. Okay, the guy in the blue
game. Pattinson for sure. Edward.
I knew in middle school, like, there was something up with me. I was like, I like men. That's 100%. But I called myself bisexual. And then freshman year in high school, I was just like, I'm gay. Like, the way I feel about women is nothing like the way I feel about men.
Okay. I already revealed mine, but what is everyone's favorite celebrity crush?
Mine is also a vampire. It's Paul Wesley from Vampire Diaries. He was like my gay awakening, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, mine was Robert Pattinson, so I'm a vampire.
Yeah, we got...
Ross Lynch. Something about that man is just... just...
He's definitely gay.
I love Ross Lynch. Yeah.
Prince and Idris Elba.
Mine right now, I think, is Pedro Pascal.
You're on the Pedro Pascal
he's
train.
So cute. Yeah.
I'm your daddy.
Matt Bomer, from White Collar. Love, like, the snake eyes are so sexy. Like, that's it.
What do you guys hate about straight men?
Their inability to, like, take criticism or take no as an answer.
Yeah.
Like, what is up with that? Like, I understand patriarchy and all that, but still.
I know, like, consent.
Literally.
Their inability to have any sort of fashion, it's just t-shirts.
Just about to
and
say
jeans.
That.
T-shirts, jeans, or, like, just basketball shorts.
It's the guy right there!
Who clearly use, like, the 3-in-1 shampoos, and I'm just like,
oh my gosh.
How?
They brush their teeth with it.
Yeah, like, I swear.
Oh my god, this one guy had a 10-in-1. I did not even want to ask.
What is a 10-in-1?
Lucifer, I just wanted to ask you,
there's a 10-in-1 shampoo?
15 is when you knew, right? That you were gay?
Yes, that's when I came to terms with it for myself.
And then you said, during COVID was when you told your brother?
Yes.
So that whole time he didn't know?
No.
Really, how did that feel for you? Because were you guys close, or?
We were, but I moved from Memphis when I was 18.
Okay.
We've been long distance for all that time.
I see.
He really didn't make a big deal out of it, just told me that he loved me, no matter what.
Lucifer?
Can I ask, why did you not come out to him earlier?
His name is Lucifer?
What's that? We're supporters?
Yes, so for me, when I was growing up, the thing that mattered most was getting married and having a family. I had to keep that facade a long time. I was actually practicing to be a minister in 2012, right when President Obama declared gay marriage legalized nationwide. And when I was in...
I want to hear more.
Hey, have you spotted the mole yet? Well, hang tight because we're going to get there. Until then, subscribe to our channel. And now let's get back to the video.
I think. Wow, it's very divided.
The top that he's wearing is really tacky.
Sorry, just the jeans and his shirt.
Wow. What a close. Kind of close.
Good luck, guys.
I think the guy in the jeans is definitely gay.
Kind of hurted.
Why do you think they were suspicious?
I think I think this guy's definitely gay.
Mainly because I'm wearing just jeans and a t-shirt, but I look stylish and I look amazing, so.
Lucifer, I remember you were mentioning that like gay marriage was being legalized in 2012, but it was 2015, right?
2013.
Yeah, that's 2013.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So like,
he got it wrong. He's straight.
I remember it precisely. I was on the phone with my pastor actually when that announcement was made.
He was running in 2012, so yeah, he would have.
Right.
So 15, 16? I'm bad at math.
I'm terrible.
Well, it took a while for it to actually.
He's backtracking. He's definitely straight.
So you can't say 2012, but if you're technically yes, it did take a few years into that second term before it was actually registered. What are some things?
Oh, he was right.
Oh, creativity, style.
Wait a minute.
Confidence.
Number one would be hygiene.
Yeah.
I bathe at least twice a day, if you know, if not more.
We're in a drought.
So,
not even.
Baby, please.
Twice a day.
I gotta freshen up. So I expect that from someone else.
Yeah. No, I get that. Yeah. Yeah, my boyfriend, my ex-boyfriend.
Oh, no.
Yeah, every time I'd come in, like, the room was just super messy. And, like, I'm really big on bathroom cleanliness.
Mm. Yes. Mm. It's the last place you are at night and the first place you are in the morning.
Exactly.
And most traditional men are just dirty in the bathrooms.
Right.
For me, definitely funny. And, I mean, obviously, you have to look good. Like, that's yeah, that's not starter, though.
Mine is basically somebody that could just hang and vibe with me. I'm a very active person, whether that be like I'm going out hiking, go out working out. Height doesn't really matter. I mean, haven't found anybody as tall as me yet.
How are you?
6'6".
Okay.
Damn!
6'2", but I have these on right now, so a little bit taller.
I love those, by the way.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, they're brand new. They're Doc Martens.
Me too. Look at.
I love Docs.
These are the brand new model. They have little.
Yeah, I know. I saw those. I saw those.
Did we miss the memo that we were supposed to wear boots today?
Yes.
Yeah, I did.
You know,
I do prefer men that are shorter than me, a little more on the submissive side.
We're out.
I hate the bottom.
I'm just being
honest. I guess because I was in such a controlled environment for so many years, I just have a way of controlling that space. Okay. Mm.
Can we run down and say what we are? Like, you already answered.
Yes.
We'll say bottom.
Top.
Or verse.
Top verse. I say I'm a verse top.
Yeah, verse bottom.
What's a verse top?
He's definitely a bottom.
Ricky is a bottom for sure. Did you see what this man was wearing? Had the midriff and all.
Yeah, just takes the right person for me.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's very dependent. But honestly, like, the verse comes in more so when it's with, like, hookups and stuff like that.
Well, baby, I'm a Scorpio, so, like.
Me too. Oh, nice.
So nice.
That's a bro move.
Dapped up Lucifer.
That was a little straight.
That felt very hetero to me. Oh. Ew.
Oh, and my other thing.
Ew.
If they're open to threesomes.
I might be wrong.
I want to do that.
Hey, say it to the camera. He's looking.
If you're out there and you're open to threesomes, Lucifer is available. Right here.
I think it's better on paper. I just want to break the truth to you.
Really?
Because it's just like, it's just another person. It just gets a lot. I don't know.
Is.
I just feel like,
I completely agree. It's more of a novelty, for sure.
Is it like a lot of just sitting around? Or
sitting around, you just one waiting.
When's it my turn, guys?
No, it's like two at a time. I mean, it's like great.
Let's do a round of smash or pass.
How does gay threesomes work? Is it like
human
centipede?
Creed 3.
Oh my god.
Creed 3. The Rock. Oh my god.
Wait, that's so surprising to me because you said that you were top, like you like being in control.
Dude, The Rock?
Yeah.
He's picking like people shorter
than you. Wait.
Yeah, I am.
But The Rock is huge.
I've been watching wrestling for a long time too.
Yeah, I think he's straight.
Ain't nobody talking. Top in The Rock, come on.
I think
That's sus. Rock's ugly.
Oh, wait, I think they got them all out. I honestly think
good luck, gentlemen.
They probably did.
Let's all screw up again.
Oh, they bitches. They jealous. They see I'm totally star power. They just didn't want to share the money with me. I'm not someone that gets offended easily. But bitch, that offended me. I am offended. This is the shit I'm talking about. This makes no damn sense. Look at me. What? Do I look straight to you?
Yes, yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Do you want to continue playing because you think that there's potentially still a liar among the four of you in the box? Raise your hand on three, all right? One,
you're gonna raise your hand.
Two, three.
Wait, raise your hand and just continue playing?
Yes.
I'm not sure.
So you four are confident that the mole is out. Is that correct?
I think so.
I can unconfidently say.
Yeah. These are like my besties right here.
Besties. So that means the game has ended.
That's it? That's the quickest game ever.
The box turns green. You have correctly voted the mole out, and you four will share a cash prize. I think it's green. If the box turns red, that means the mole is still among you four, and they win the cash prize themselves. Are you guys ready?
I honestly think they did. They got the mole out. Or the blue shirt.
Oh my god.
It's the blue shirt!
I was uncomfortable.
He dabbed him up. He dabbed Lucifer up.
I said. Why would I act surprised? This is...
He's not even surprised. Wait, none of them surprised.
Alright.
Wait, none of them surprised.
So the mole has won. Uh-huh. And on the count of three, I'm gonna have the mole step forward. One.
The mole.
Two.
Who is it? Blue shirt.
It's three. Blue
shirt. Huh? They all stepped up? They're all moles?
What?
We're all the moles?
Let's go. I think there was a mix-up, you guys.
No way. The two on the side from left to the right.
I was very confused.
They're definitely gay.
You had me with the fit, Ricky.
For real?
Yes.
Gave them my girlfriend's tea.
Yeah.
I thought everybody misheard the question.
Dude, I took a step and I was like, are these people stupid? Like, why is everyone else stepping up? Like, I'm only straight. Dude, y'all are gay.
I thought
what the
everyone
fuck?
was gay.
And either of you ever been mistaken as gay or more feminine?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
For a long time.
I know. Every night I feel like when I go out with my friends or whatever, I get hit on by more guys than girls sometimes. And. It's very common, yeah.
I got mistaken for being gay a lot of the time. I'll be honest, I went on dates with guys because so many people were suspecting me of it, but I was just like, that's not me. After being on those dates, I was like, I like women.
He's bi.
That's a fact.
My story that I was telling was very genuine. I'd suppressed my alternative to being macho straight for a long time because I just don't fit the mold for the typical straight guy. There's always questions of, is he or isn't he?
Fucking hell, dude.
I've been training for this for a week.
How did you train for it?
Bro, I FaceTimed all my gay homies. They were saying like, I'm gonna be a verse top because that's like the least sus, but it's also gay. Dude, I practiced walking.
Damn, he's been practicing, bro.
I was doing like 360 Snapchat videos. Like, damn, do I look gay or not? Like, does my ass pop?
I work at Urban Outfitters.
You want that money?
There's a lot of gay men. He helped me pick up this nail polish.
I called all my gay friends. And I watched like a whole bunch of drag. I watched so much drag, bro.
Damn, they all study.
And it's actually really good. So I would probably keep watching.
Put that work in school.
I think my game plan was to just not offend anybody. I hope I stuck to that. Because I'm very inclusive.
I applied for this episode because especially right now with the whole red pill movement, Aiden Ross, Andrew Tate, the toxic male influences out there, that it's very important to show like other men and especially younger men that are coming up into this world that it is okay to be feminine. Is it okay to express your emotions? Is it okay to be vulnerable?
Accept everyone. It doesn't matter what your looks, sexuality, gender are. Just accept everyone. Yeah. Everyone's a little bit different.
And don't be mad if you're not as confident as the people who are.
Like not jumping to conclusions and not like stereotyping anyone.
Bro, that guy.
Speak for themselves.
His girlfriend's top.
I changed my locks into a dude as well, bro. This is my homie Nick.
Bruh.
He's in the bed. I said, yo, send me a selfie with your nipple. You send it. Yeah.
I put a picture of
He's committed.
Like,
yeah. They're all committed.
I'll do. Because I was like, if I turn my phone on, they see my phone.
Like,
I was
show
like,
me your locks. Yeah.
Damn, they committed.
That's not props. That's just a way for you to make more money.